Hello friends, in my previous lecture of the chapter polynomial, I told you about the definition of the polynomial, types of polynomials and degree, many more things. Now we are discussing about and one more thing I told you about the remainder theorem. After that, I will tell you about the factor theorem. By the way, there is no too much difference between remainder theorems and factor theorems. Actually, when we divide one polynomial by another polynomial and the remainder comes zero, what does it mean? The divisor is a factor of this polynomial. So that is only a difference. If a remainder comes zero, what does it mean? The term by which we are dividing, this is a factor of it. Okay. So using this remainder theorem, one question I am writing here. Suppose we are going to check that without actual long division procedure to find out whether it is a factor, yes or no, or we are going to find the value of the term. So suppose a question I am taking, let a question is x cube minus ax square plus 6x minus a is divided by x minus a. Then what is the remainder? That means we are finding the remainder without actual long division calculation. Okay. So one cubic polynomial I am writing, x cube minus ax square, x cube minus ax square plus 6x minus a, plus 6x minus a is divided by x minus a, is divided by x minus a. Then what is the remainder of it? After division, what would be the remainder? This we are finding. So for finding the remainder, we can use the remainder factor theorem, whatever it is. So remainder theorem, what the remainder theorem says, if x minus a is a linear polynomial, what is the zero of it? The zero of x minus a is a. Why it is a? In my last lecture, I told you that whatever the value of x we can put here and the result comes zero, what does it mean? This term will be a zero. So here I can put x is equal to a minus a, that is 0. That means the 0 is a. Now put x is equal to a in x cube minus ax square plus 6x minus a. So I'll substitute the value in place of x, there's a. It is coming a cube minus a in place of x, again it is a square plus 6x a minus a. This means a cube as it is, since it is a loss of exponent can be used here, a to the power 1, this is a to the power 2, bases are same, power will be added. So it is coming minus a cube, 2 plus 1, 3, plus 6a minus a. Plus a cube minus a cube cancel, 6a minus a, it is 5a. What is this 5a? This 5a is a remainder of it. So the remainder is 5a. So that is the use of remainder theorem. Same as factor theorem also can be used. Okay. Now after that factor theorem, we are using the factor theorem and find the value of k if x minus 1 is a factor of another term. Like this. If it is given that a particular polynomial is a factor of that. Suppose if x minus 1 is a factor of, if x minus 1 is a factor of 2x square plus kx plus root 2. 2x square plus kx plus root 2. Friends, in this question clearly it is mentioned that x minus 1 is a factor of this polynomial, then find the value of k. Then find the value of k. So using factor theorem, because clearly it is mentioned that x minus 1 is a factor. What does it mean? If x minus 1 is a factor, that means when I put x minus 1 is equal to 0, that means x is equal to 1. So that means the 0 of this polynomial is 1. this 1 will be substituted here. 2 in place of x, there's a 1 plus k again in place of x, 1 plus under root 2. This is equal to 0. Why it is 0? Because what the factor theorem says, if this term is a factor of 8, what does it mean? It will divide it completely. That means the remainder comes 0. So that means when we substitute the term here, this result is equal to 0. Now we'll calculate it and find the value of k. So 2 square of 1, that is 1, plus k plus under root 2 is equal to 0. 2 ones are 2, plus k plus root 2 is equal to 0. Since we are finding the value of k, so other terms will be shifted from left to right. So the value of k is equal to minus 2 plus under root 2. That is the value of k. Okay. So in this sequence, one more thing I would like to discuss with you, that the factorization of quadratic and cubic polynomial. So I am taking one example. First I am taking a quadratic polynomial and how to factorize that. That means how to find out the zeros. And second, we'll have to take cubic polynomial and find out the zeros. Okay. So I am taking one simple example here. The example is, example I am taking here, 12x square minus 7x, 12x square minus 7x plus 1, 12x square minus 7x plus 1. What is it? Again, let us check everything. It is a polynomial. Yes, it is a polynomial, because again, we'll have to check through the definition. It is a combination of variable and non-variable term, and power on variable should be non-negative integer. Therefore, it is a polynomial. And how many terms present in it? There are 1, 2, 3 terms present. That means it is a polynomial. And which type of this polynomial? It is a trinomial, because there are 3 terms in it. The order of this polynomial is 2. Highest power on the variable is 2, therefore order of 2. And in my previous lecture, I told you, when the highest power on the variable is 2 of a polynomial, that means the number of zeros present, maximum zeros present, 2. Okay. So here we are trying to find the maximum zeros 2. For that, we have a different procedure. I am using here splitting the middle term. So that is a quadratic polynomial. It is a quadratic polynomial, and 2 zeros are possible. How to find out the zeros? I am using here splitting the middle term. Friends, splitting the middle term, that means first term and last term. We are not doing with these terms anything. We are going to split this 7x. But at the time of splitting the 7x, we have to remember one thing. This is the coefficient of, first of all, the coefficient of x square is 12, and the constant term, that is 1. So we'll multiply them, 12 by 12. That means which two number will be multiplied? The coefficient of x square and constant term to be multiplied first. Result is 12. Now we'll have to read a table in which 12 comes. So 12 comes in 1 into 12, 12 by 12. 2 into 6, 2 6 is 12. 3 into 4, 4 3 is 12. Got it? These are the pairs. 1 into 12, 2 into 6, 3 into 4. Out of these 3, we are going to select 1. Okay. Which one should be selected? Look at that. Now let us see the middle term. The coefficient of x, that is 7. Coefficient of x is 7. That means we are selecting one of the terms in such a way that their sum or difference of 2 numbers should be 7. And sum of difference of 2 numbers should be 7. So out of these 3, you can see this is the term 3 and 4. 3 plus 4 is 7. Since it is a minus sign, so there's no problem at all. Minus remains outside. In bracket, we will write here 3 plus 4. So 3 plus 4 is equal to 7, and 3 4 is 12. So we are selecting 2 numbers in such a way so that we can split this middle term in this way. Okay. I hope you have understood it. Now let us start. 12x square, I am not changing anything, writing as it is, 12x square. This minus sign, no change, as it is. Splitting the middle term, the name of this term, what does it mean? This 7 will be split into two parts. These two parts will be 3 and 4. 3 plus 4. X outside plus 1. After that, 12x square. Now when I open the bracket, outside the bracket there is a minus sign. That means the minus multiplied by 3 with x. Minus 3x. Minus 4 multiplied by x. Minus 4x. Plus 1. Now you can see there were 3 terms. Now they are 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. Now we are trying to take common from the first 2 terms, any number. And from the last 2 terms, any one number. So what is common from first 2 terms? You can see this 12 is a factor of 3 and 4. That means 12 can be written 3 multiplied by 4. So I can write here 3 into 4 in place of 12. X square minus 3x minus 4x plus 1. Other terms remains as it is. No change. From the first and second term, you can see this 3 and 1x. Out of these two, 1x is common. So I am taking 3x common. Got it? The time when we take 3x common, immediate will put the bracket. Remaining terms in this first term, 3 is out, 1x is out, so 4 and 1x is left. Minus sign as it is, 3x completely out, nothing is here, it is 1. Since it is a minus sign, so I am taking minus. With minus, if nothing is there, that means with minus 1 is common. So I have taken here minus 1 common. So it becomes 4x. This plus is plus minus minus and 1. And friends, it's very important when you reach to this step, you can check yourself whether both the terms in a bracket, 4x minus 1, 4x minus 1 with the sign should be coming exact same. Only then your algorithm process is correct. So here, I think our procedure is correct. 4x minus 1, 4x minus 1. It's okay. Now there are two terms, term 1 and term 2. I am taking 4x minus 1 common. So since I take 4x minus 1 common, remaining term 3x minus 1. There are two factors. So what does it mean? Factorize the term. So I have factorized the term. That is one. These are the factors. 4x minus 1 is a one factor. 3x minus 1 another factor. And these two factors, with the help of these two factors, if you divide this polynomial, remainder will come 0. That is one. Second, we are going to find the zeros. So zeros are 4x minus 1. Again, the same procedure in 4x minus 1. In place of x, which number should be substituted so that the result is 0. So of course the x is 1 upon 4, so that 4 and 4 cancel, minus 1. Like this, 4, 1 upon 4 minus 1. 4, 4 cancel, plus 1 minus 1, 0. That means zeros are 1, 0 is 1 upon 4. And second 0, 3x minus 1, 3x minus 1, 3, I will write here in place of x, that is 1 upon 3 minus 1. Again 3, 3 cancel, it is 0. So second 0 is 1 upon 3. So that means the zeros of this quadratic polynomial is 1 upon 4 and 1 upon 3. These are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. So we have got two things in that. First, we understood that how to factorize the quadratic polynomial. This is the procedure. It's considered as a splitting the middle term. And second one is how to find the zeros. So once we get the factor, after that we can find the zeros. Now I'm taking second cubic polynomial. One example, let x cube minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5. Minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5. What is it? It is a cubic polynomial. Why it is cubic? Because you can see that the order of this polynomial is 3. Therefore, it is a cubic polynomial. We are finding two things in it. Number one, factorize. That means 3 factors possible in it. And second, we are finding the 3 zeros. Got it? So first of all, we are finding the factorize. For finding the factorization, we have many methods, two or three methods I have. I will use two methods in front of you so that you can understand both the methods. So this is a cubic polynomial and I am finding factors of this cubic polynomial, or I am finding the zeros of this cubic polynomial. How many zeros possible? There are three zero possible. Okay, so let us start. First of all, the simplest and very conventional method is, since it is a cubic polynomial, we are using trial and error method. What the trial and error method says, which says, in place of x, we start putting the value 1, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 3, using the factor theorem, and check it whether the 0 comes or not, or the 0 comes on which number. Okay, so I'll start putting the value, put x is equal to 1. Put x is equal to 1 here. Now let us see what is the result is coming. If the remainder comes 0, what does it mean? X minus 1 is a factor. So first of all, this is considered as a trial and error method. Put x is equal to 1. Here I am putting the value of x 1, 1 cube minus 3 into 1 square minus 9, 1 and minus 5. What I have done? In place of x, I put 1. This is 1 minus 3 minus 9 and minus 5. And the result is minus 5 minus 9 minus 14 minus 3 minus 17 plus 1 minus 16, which is not equal to 0. That means this trial and error is not correct. Now we will put x is equal to minus 1. Put x is equal to minus 1. Friends, this process continues. Put x is equal to 1, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 3, until 0 will come. So put x is equal to minus 1. Here's a minus 1, minus 1 cube, minus 3, minus 1 square, minus 9, minus 1, minus 5. That is, of course, minus 1. It is minus 1 whole square, that means it is plus 1, minus 3, minus 3, minus into minus plus 9, minus 5. Now let us check, negative term should be added, minus 5, minus 3, minus 8, minus 1, minus 9, plus 9 is equal to 0. It comes 0. And if it comes 0, what does it mean? X is equal to minus 1. That means x plus 1. That means x plus 1 is equal to 0. If I shift this minus 1 from right to left, it will come x plus 1 is equal to 0. X plus 1 is equal to 0, what does it mean? X plus 1 is a factor of this cubic polynomial. Got it? And if x plus 1 is a factor of it, what does it mean? When I divide by x plus 1 to this cubic polynomial, the remainder comes 0, and whatever the quotient is there, that would be a quadratic polynomial. It's okay. X plus 1. So I am taking here x plus 1. X plus 1. And the cubic polynomial is x cube minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5. I have already explained in front of you that how to divide by the long division method by one polynomial to another polynomial. Once again, it is x cube. We are selecting a number or term here in such a way that the first term must be x cube. Second term or third term, whatever it is, it doesn't matter. But first term should be properly matched with it. So I am taking here x square, because x square multiplied by x, it is x cube. So it is x cube. This x square is multiplied by the second term also, plus x square. When we subtract the second term from the first term, always the signs of the second term will be changed. It is plus minus, this is minus. Cancel. Minus 3x square minus 1x square minus 4x square. Remaining term should be copied properly. Next is minus 4x square. What should be taken here? Since it is a minus sign with 4, it is minus 4. And of course, there is a single x, x square, so 1x is also needed. Minus 4x multiplied by 1 minus 4x square.
minus 4x plus 1, it is minus 4x. Sign change, it is cancel. Minus 9x plus 4x, it is minus 5x, minus 5. Which number should be taken now here? Here we have to take minus 5. Minus 5, minus 5x, minus 5. Again sign change, cancel, and comes 0. As already I told you, since this is a factor, therefore the remainder will come 0. That means the meaning is this term, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So this dividend is equal to x cube minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5 is equal to, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient. May I write x plus 1 and quotient x square minus 4x minus 5 plus remainder 0. It doesn't mean, so I cannot write here plus 0 here. This term is equal to that one. So one thing is understood, that this we have divided into two factors. But this is a linear factor, it's okay. We can get immediate 0 here, but it is a quadratic polynomial. Again, we are solving it and finding two zeros. So this is x plus 1 as it is. Second term, x square minus 4x minus 5. It is a quadratic polynomial, and again using splitting the middle term for finding the zeros. Splitting the middle term, the procedure which I told you, the coefficient of x square and the constant term will be multiplied. Since coefficient of x square is nothing, which is to be considered as 1. 1 is multiplied by 5, and we start reading the table in which 5 comes. So 5 ones are 5, and 5 minus 1, it is 4. 4 is here. So that means x square, and this minus 4x can be written minus 5x plus 1x. 5 minus 5 plus 1, that is minus 4x minus 5. Got it? Same procedure I have done. I skipped only the one procedure which I have done in the previous one. X plus 1 as it is. From here, again, there are number of terms 4. From the first two, I am taking common x. What is left here? X minus 5 plus 1 common. It is x minus 5. In my last question, I told you that we will check it, that these two terms should be coming properly correct with signs also. X minus 5, here x minus 5. So we are going in right direction. X minus 5 as it is. X minus 5 common. That is x plus 1. Now we can see here x plus 1, x minus 5, and of course x plus 1. What are these three? These are the factor of this cubic polynomial. Since it is a cubic, how many factors possible? 3 factors. These are the factors. Now we are finding the zeros. For finding the zeros, again using 1 by 1. X plus 1. What is the 0 in the x plus 1? That means which number should be substituted in place of x so that the result is 0? 1. So zeros. It is 1. For x minus 5, we can put here 5. For x plus 1, again it is, sorry, this x plus 1 is equal to 0. If I will put here 1, then it is coming 1 plus 1, 2. But we want 0. So here is a minus 1. X minus 5, so it is a 5. X plus 1, again same, minus 1. So zeros are minus 1, 5, and minus 1. So friends, this is the method which can be used for finding the zero of any type of cubic polynomial. Any type of cubic polynomial using trial and error method. Start putting 1, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 3. And I think up to putting 3, minus 3, we will get the 0. So that will be a factor, and after that we start solving it. I have another method of it also that I am telling you. So another method is, first of all, we will see that it is a cubic polynomial. And in the cubic polynomial, number of terms present here, 1, 2, 3, 4. How many terms present here? There are total 4 terms present. Let us see If I'll take anything common from the first two, suppose x square is common here, so it is x minus 3. But here nothing can be taken common, inside it is 9x plus 5 will be left. So because these two terms are not same, therefore direct we cannot solve it, but I have a different method for it. Different method is, x cube I am writing as it is, no change in it, minus the coefficient of x square will be split into two parts. Here, x square as it is, minus, this is coefficient of x will be split into two parts, x and minus 5. Now let me tell you why I have keep these two brackets blank. Because we will start putting the value from right, from my right. Look at this, minus 5, here is a 5. So 5 I have to write here, this 5 is writing here. Coefficient of x is 9, already I have written here 5. What is left here? 9 minus 5, it is 4. 4 is writing here. 4 plus 5 you can match, 4 plus 5 it is 9 minus 9. This term is absolutely correct. 4 plus 5, 9 minus 9, minus 9. X as it is minus 5. Got it? After that, this is the first term 4. Here I have to write 4. But since it is a 3, minus 9 is already there. Since it is 3. So how to write, or which number should be written here so that the overall value of this term will be 3. For writing the overall value of this term will be 3, I can write here minus 1 plus 4. Minus 1 plus 4, because 4 minus 1, 3 plus 3, and this minus sign is already there. So these are two brackets will be filled like that. Minus 1 plus 4, it is 3. 4 plus 5, it is 9. Next term, now I am going to open all the brackets. X cube minus with minus, it is plus 1 x square. When I open the bracket, so with minus, actually it is not only minus, it is minus 1 with x square. So it is minus x square will be multiplied to all the terms. X square plus minus, it is minus 4 x square. Open this bracket, minus 4 minus 4 with x, minus 5 with x, and minus 5. How many terms here now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 6 terms, that means we are making a pair of 2, 2. First 2 terms, 1 pair, middle 2 terms, second pair, last 2 terms, third pair. And taking common, x cube plus x square. X square common, here it is left, 1x plus 1. From middle two terms, since it is minus 4x square, minus 4x, easily we can take minus 4x common. If I take minus 4x common, minus already here, so it is coming x, this minus becomes plus, it is 1. Now last two terms, minus 5x minus 5, I'll take minus 5 common. Again, it is x and this is plus 1. And friends, you can see inside the bracket, x plus 1, x plus 1 and x plus 1. So I'll take x plus 1 common. Remaining terms, I'm writing in this square bracket. X square minus 4x minus 5. Now we got two factors. X plus 1 as it is, again it is a quadratic polynomial which is to be solved by splitting the middle term. So using the splitting the middle term, already we have done it in this first procedure question. X square minus 4x, coefficient of x square 1, it is 5, 5 points are 5, so minus 5x plus 1x minus 5. This means x plus 1, taking common from first two terms, x is common, it is x minus 5 plus 1 x minus 5. Next term, x plus 1 remains as it is. What is common from these two terms? Because these are considered as a term number 1, it is term number 2. X minus 5 is common. This term remains x plus 1. Now you can see that there are three factors, x plus 1, x minus 5, and it is x plus 1. Same three factors we got it, x plus 1, x minus 5, and x plus 1. Zeros are, again using the same thing, x plus 1, which number should be substituted in place of x, so that the result comes 0, it is minus 1. Minus 1, it is plus 5, and that is minus 1. So these are three zeros, we got it. And you can check both the zeros, minus 1, 5, minus 1, the same zeros we have got by this method also. Okay. So these are the two methods. And one more thing I'd like to tell you, in case suppose a question is there in which if you can direct take common from the first two terms anything and from the last two terms anything, and in the bracket the number of terms are exactly same, then simply we can take common and solve it. Otherwise, if it is not taking common and term is not correct, we are using this method. And if it is very difficult or you are unable to get these terms in place of that, then the method is, this method is considered as a trial and error method, that is a solution of each and every type of questions. Friends, these two questions I have written here. These are the question based on the factorize. Cubic polynomials are there. Okay, you can use whatever the method you want. I think either you can use what is the name of it, trial and error method, or the method which I told you, splitting the midterm. So please keep practicing.